Vinhas!
Don't send them away.
Thank you, Percy. That will do.
Please, sir.
Thank you. Come again.
Please, sir.
Thank you. Come again.
Please, sir.
I'm sorry. Thank you. Come again.
Whenever they did anything that Duke thought wrong, he would say,
Gordon was cross and didn't care what he did. He waited till the table was halfway round.
I'll show them, I'll show them, he hissed.
I'll show them, I'll show them, I'll show them, I'll show them.
I'll show them, I'll show them.
I'll show them, I'll show them.
He moved slowly forward to jam the table, but he couldn't stop himself and slithered into a ditch.
Get me out! Get me out!
Not a hope, said his driver and fireman. You're stuck, you silly great engine. Don't you understand that?
No!
On the other side of the ditch, some little boys were chattering.
Oh, doesn't he look silly?
They'll never get him out. They began to sing.
Okay, okay!
The trucks decided to carry out their plan when they reached Gordon's Hill. When they were nearly at the top, they played their tricks. Ready, steady, go, said the trucks, and they jerked at a coupling which broke. We're making your wish come true, Toad. Follow the leader, yelled the trucks. Toad was still in a state of shock, so didn't know what to think, and he couldn't ask the guard. He had jumped clear.
Oh,
suddenly, Toad found it all rather fun, but the fun was soon over. There ahead was Gordon. The signalman changed the points just in time.
What the f*** is that?
James turned much too easily. The wind puffed him round like a top. He couldn't stop.
They stopped outside the tunnel. The workman went inside. It was very dark and quiet, but not for long. Call the fire controller.
Dinner.
Shut up!
Sega!
Shut up!
This went on and on till the diesel's eyes popped out.
No!
He fussed into the station where Gordon was waiting. Hurry up, you, said Gordon.
Shut up!
Thank you.